Hello, Generals, and welcome back to this Wednesday edition of the 5-Star News. I'm Jacob Morris.
And I'm Mason Dotson. We're going to get you guys started like we always do with some school announcements and weather. So here's Heritage Happenings with Nathan McCoy and Pierce Monroe.
Thanks, guys, for an awesome intro. Now, let's jump right into some Wednesday announcements. Attention, juniors and seniors. Don't forget to buy your prom tickets before the prices go up. They are only $65, but will increase closer to prom. The annual event will be held at Collinsdale Commons on April the 23rd at 7. Don't forget, cheerleading tryouts are coming up quickly. You can try out for competition or spirit. The tryouts will be on March 28th. There will be a $15 tryout fee. If you're interested in trying out, review the packet on the school website. Next up, our Heritage tennis team will be taking on Ringgold here at the Todge later this afternoon, if weather permits. The matches will start at 4. Come out and support your team. Now, let's get you over to Pierce for your weather forecast.
Thanks, Nathan, for those great announcements. Now on to your 3-day weather forecast. Wednesday, there will be an 80% chance of rain with a high of 62 and a low of 50. Thursday, it will be cloudy with a high of 72 and a low of 48. And for Friday, there will be a 70% chance of rain, and there will be a high of 65 and a low of 49. Now let's get you back to our anchors for more news.
Thanks, you two. Moving on to some news now. There's some pretty important things happening down in the English department.
Sure is. The HHS English teachers are holding their annual book fair.
They are asking students to bring in new or gently used books for a great cause.
That's right. And the book fair wraps up this week. We had 5-Star News reporters Evan Wingrove and Brandon Hamilton catch up with Miss Tollett about this week's fair.
Hello. National English Honor Society is taking up books. It's a book donation. We're looking for gently used books that you're finished with and you would like to donate. We're taking them up through Wednesday, March 16th. You can take them to any English teacher. The idea is that at the end of the year, we'll sort them out and we'll take them to elementary schools, middle schools, high schools to give to kids who need books, who want books over the summer, who don't have books of their own or maybe can't make it to the library so that they can have the pleasure of reading over the summer.
Great stuff there by our English department. Now we're going to dive into another career tech class.
Yes, Ms. Henley and Ms. Johnson's HOSA group spent the past weekend in Atlanta competing in their annual state competition.
Some students stole a silver medal. Here's 5-Star News reporters Bailey Moorhead and Aaliyah Hensley with the report.
Okay, this is Ms. Henley, and last week we took a group of HOSA students to Atlanta, Georgia to compete for state in HOSA state competition. And we're super excited that they placed and they did really well. Will Waldrop did well in prepared speaking. Jed Johnson and Christopher Simmons made it through two rounds in CPR and first aid before they got knocked out. But it was a really tough competition and they did great. And we did have Ms. Kayla Stevens place second in the whole state for dental science, and we're very proud of her. We spent two nights and had a great time. We had kids participate in the courtesy corps and go to different classes, learn about a lot of different things, and we'll be excited to go again next year.
Hey, so HOSA went down to Atlanta for the state leadership conference, and we had a blast. So just a little background. To go down to state leadership conference in Atlanta, you had to test here at Regents in a specific area. So like I tested in CPR and first aid. We had some tests in medical terminology, dental science, and things like that. And if you made it past Regents, you got to go to state and compete there and hopefully make it into the top three state to go to nationals. We actually had one person go make it into the top three, and that's Kayla Stevens. She placed second in dental science, so we're so proud of her. Me and my partner Chris Simmons, we placed in the top 15 for CPR and first aid. So not the best finish, but it was a great finish for us. And then the other there was more kids that got to go, and they got to attend little workshops to where, you know, they can kind of see their career pathways or just fun little classes like, you know, learning how to stop a bleed on if somebody's bleeding or just things like that. So we had a ton of fun. It was very beneficial for all of us, and we can't wait to go back next year.
This past weekend, I went to the HOSA State Leadership Conference, and I competed in dental science, and I placed second in the state. Basically, what I did was, for the first round, I took a test over just some basic dental things, and then the second round, I did some skills. I made an alginate impression. I'm very proud of myself, and I'm surprised at how far I was able to get. And I'm very excited to be going to the national competition in Nashville soon.
Congrats to all the students that competed, and good luck in nationals.
Shifting gears now to a pretty cool event that's taking place in Mr. Carter's room.
That's right. Mr. Carter, earlier in the semester, asked his students to make a presentation on somebody that inspires them.
I bet the freshmen love that one.
And it gets even better. Not only did his class do this, they also got some of the HHS faculty involved to make their presentation as well.
Okay, now that's awesome.
Yep. How's the presentations going? Well, here's five-star news reporters Brody Irvin, Claire Martin, and Charlie Williams with more on the report.
Yes, so for my class this semester, one of the things that I've instituted is something I call daily dedications. And so what we do there is every single day, one of my students is going to dedicate the day to someone that inspires them. It can be real, they can be fictional, they can be alive, they can be dead, but it has to be something or someone that inspires them. And so they get 30 to 60 seconds right at the beginning of class to dedicate the day and tell the class why that person or why that character inspires them.
So Mr. Carter sent out an invitation for teachers to come and do in his class what he calls the daily dedication. And so I took advantage of that. Went up to his class this week and did that for his students. My daily dedication was Tony Dungy. Tony Dungy, most people know as a former NFL head coach, one of the greatest coaches of his era. But the reason that I picked him was not because he was an NFL coach, but because he used his role as a coach, his role as a nationally known figure, to help other people. And so really, to put it simply, he used his job not as his sole thing that he did in his life, but he used his job as a platform to help others. You know, he experienced tragedy. He had his son died while he was coaching. And so he used his position, his platform to help others. And so he wasn't so concerned with just the job that he did. He was very good at it, obviously had to be dedicated to that. But he also used it to step up to others. And so even as a teacher, I can do that. Yes, I need to teach the subject and I want to do it really well. But then as a teacher, I interact with students on a daily basis, and I can use my role as a teacher, I can use my job as a platform to step up and do a lot of other things.
Hey, so Mr. Carter and his freshman class have a pretty cool project going on right now with daily dedications, and he asked some of the faculty and staff to participate. So I went to his first and fourth block the other day and visited, and ended up dedicating my day to the girls' soccer team. I spoke about how we are working and building some pretty cool things this season, and as I am helping Coach Terry hold them accountable, I find myself holding myself to the same standards, and it's kind of just a cool thing we're building right now. They are 7-0 currently, and the girls have not yet been scored on, so we've got a pretty good start to the season, so that's what I chose to do for his daily dedication assignment.
Nice. Time to get a quick break here on the show.
Yep, but stay and stick around, because after the break, we've got sports. The guys will catch you up on baseball, soccer, and tennis.
Sports is next.
So, you want to be a ping pong master, don't you?
Of course.
Well, I can teach you. Ready to work for it?
I'm ready to be the best there ever was.
You're gonna win. You got this.
Hey. Sign up from March 7th through March 16th. And remember to pay Mr. Dodson, Miss Vennel, Miss Owens, or Officer Crane.
Wait, you picked training for this. You ready?
I'm ready.
Good.
It's March 22nd. The tournament is live, and these competitors are ready to rumble.
Leadership.
So who's my next opponent? It's hot. No. Sensei! Finally, I'm the ping pong champion. Oh, no, you!
Welcome into sports, everyone. Alex and Anderson here, and we'll start you off with baseball.
Yes, Coach Beagle's boys wrapping up a series sweep over Southeast last Thursday night before whipping up on LFO on Monday night.
They sure did. Here's Evan Wingrove and Brandon Hamilton with the game recaps.
Yeah, to recap our series with Southeast Whitfield. Game 2 and 3 we had here last Thursday. We ended up completing the sweep of Southeast. In the first game of the doubleheader, Landon Skeen pitched it, pitched extremely well, got a lot of offense support. In game 2, it was a combination of J.J. Hunt on the mound as well as J.C. Armour. J.C. Armour pitched the most he's pitched for us this year. And we also gave him some run support and played well behind him to get those two wins.
So we played Southeast last week, and we did pretty good. We hit well, and the pitching was very good that week, and there wasn't much more we could do besides hit more, I guess.
Recap with LFO, we win the game 6-5 here. Off to a little bit of a rough start, kind of weathered an early storm by them. They score 5 runs in the first inning, and Garrison May kind of settles down after the first inning and gets us out into the fifth. And then in the fifth, Brady Chandler got the save. He pitched the 6th and 7th for us. And it's the first 2 innings Brady's pitched for us in 2 years. We've been working him and doing bullpens and so forth, but yesterday was an opportunity to get him on the mound, and he did well for us there. Got just enough hits, was highlighted by Brady Chandler's triple, and the game was ended on an outstanding play by Taylor Vincent at first base to seal the win. So it kind of recaps our sweep of Southeast and also our win yesterday against LFO.
Way to go, guys. Good luck the rest of the week.
To soccer now, and our girls stayed perfect late last week as they knocked off the Dragons of Pickens County to go to 8-0 on the year.
Yep, but the boys had a more difficult time with the Dragons. Here's a look back at the girls' win and the guys' loss.
Yeah, Pickens match last Thursday, the girls were just absolutely dominant.
It went really well. We dominated the whole entire game, and we ended up scoring 11 goals in less than a half.
We did give up one goal. It was an 11-1, 40-minute match, and then they called it at halftime with a mercy rule thing. So we were just pounding the net from the very beginning. I think we scored 4 goals really quickly. Girls were moving the ball well. Molly played particularly well out of the midfield. She's had some great passes to free up the forwards. And so complete team win and a very, very dominant performance by the Lady Generals.
I definitely think it was a team effort with goals from a lot of different people, work from the defense and the midfield, and finishing on the offensive side.
Overall, it was just a good team victory for us. We were passing great, played a lot of through balls behind their defense, and so the forwards and wings were able to run onto it. We got some good crosses, just a lot of good goals from the girls, and locked down defense most of the night.
So the boys played Pickens last Thursday and did a phenomenal job on the field. We did lose to them 7-4, but Pickens is a very, very difficult team, and the guys did a great job. And the fact that we scored 4 goals on them is fantastic. Great job, guys.
So we played Pickens last Thursday, and going into the game, we knew they had 2 very good, talented players. They're actually twins, and they did most of the playmaking throughout the game as they scored 5 goals and assisted both of them. So, yeah, we had trouble shutting them down. And luckily, they won't be there next year for our other returning people. And I thought we handled them pretty well for the most part, considering they're both All-Americans. And I thought our defense really stepped up, especially in Young Kim, Owen at some points. And I was really proud of the way Tipton Smart played in the first half. To tennis now. And our boys and girls took on a rival last Thursday as Gordon Lee rolled into the Taj to tangle with Coach Green's guys and Coach Mathis's ladies.
They sure did, Alex, but neither Trojan team was up for the challenge as our team swept both matches 5-0.
And both teams were in action yesterday at Pickens as well. Let's get you over to Coach Green, who has the recaps of both matches.
Yeah, the Gordon Lee match last Thursday was a pretty good match for us. We knew going into the match that Gordon Lee was down a little bit, so it was a good opportunity for us to get out there and beat up on some teams that are not quite as good as us right now. And we did that, so that's a good thing for a coach to be able to throw your lineup out there and then just have them produce. It started right off the bat with our number one player, Nathan Mitten. He hadn't lost a match all year, and he really just destroyed the guy from Gordon Lee. It was 6-0, 6-0, and it was over really fast. So Nathan took care of business right off the bat.
So our last match on Thursday was a home game. It wasn't a region match, but it was against Gordon Lee. Their guys' team didn't have too much depth. Most of our guys won. I won 6-0, 6-0. The rest of the guys pretty much 6-0, 6-1. And it was a really fun match overall.
JT Halloran and Caleb Biddle also got easy wins, I believe 6-1, 6-0 for both of them. And then we turned it over to our doubles teams, and that trend just kept going. I think we lost five total games the whole match, and that's five matches. So good stuff for us against Gordon Lee, and a good to get back in the win column after losing to Central Carrollton a couple of weeks ago.
Hi, so the Gordon Lee match went well last week. We ended up winning all five matches, so that was great. I was very proud of our girls because our two and three singles really had to fight hard to win. It ended up both of them had to do a tiebreaker, so it was a long, stressful match for everyone, but we ended up pulling out the win, so I'm very proud of how they fought back.
Pickens County match went really well for the boys. It was kind of a rush deal. We actually left the school at 12:30 on Tuesday to get up there, and the rain was kind of coming in, so fortunately for us, their coach was able to get their students out of class, and we got to start our match a little bit earlier than normal, and our boys responded in a big way. Sometimes you get in a hurry, you kind of tense up, you might not be able to put your guy away, but that didn't happen for us at Pickens. Our number one, two, and three singles won just like that, so that really clinched the match, and it was over probably in about 30 minutes, and then our doubles team of Walker and Anderson got out there and did the same thing, so we get a win 4-0. Jed and Tanner Eady were leading 6-0 when the rain did finally cancel the match. But for us, we got the win in the region. That's a big win for us. Pickens, it's a long drive. It's tough to play sometimes up there. But our guys had no problem with them.
Well, my match started off slow. It was a lot of noise around the courts. And I was playing a lefty, Holton, super nice guy. Gave me a lot of balls that were out and called them in for me. So we had a fun, long match. But it ended up going in my favor.
Well, it was awesome to get that region win today. Felt good. I played pretty good. It's great overall for the team. We really needed that. It's going to set us for a better place in region.
Well, it was a little bit weird changing the courts. The colors are different over here. The nets seem to be a slight bit higher, so we had to sort of adjust to that. Lost the first game, but after that we just kept rolling and didn't stop, and we got the 6-1, 6-0 win.
So now it's getting down to the nitty-gritty. We're going to have two tough region teams coming in here in the next couple of weeks, Northwest and Cedartown, and those matches are going to decide if we're going to be number two in the region or as low as three. So we need to win both of those, and that's going to put us in a good spot for the region tournament.
Thanks to Sportsy, guys, and now moving on to our entertainment segments for today.
That's right, and we're going to start you guys off here in our own drama department.
Yep. Here at the 5-Star News, we got a sneak peek of the new play, Godspell. Here's 5-Star News reporters Ethan Anderson, Pinner Allen, and Emma Youngblood with more on the report.
So this spring, we are producing Godspell, and basically it's just about the book of Matthew, and it follows Jesus and his disciples all the way up to his crucifixion. So it's really cool. It's been done a lot in our area, and it's really fun. It's kind of based off of 70s music, and the kids really enjoy it, so we're excited to do it. It will be March 31st, April 1st, and April 2nd, and then we will do performances that week for the high school.
So Godspell is a bunch of, like, it's a retelling of the gospel, and so it's just a bunch of, like, players, and they recreate the parables themselves. They just tell the stories. And there's a lot of, it's great music, Stephen Schwartz. It's like a rock musical almost. It's wonderful music. I am so excited for the musical throughout the entire like process of Matilda. I would go up to people and I'd be like, I'm so excited for Godspell. It's just like whenever I heard we were doing Godspell, I was like, oh, I can't wait. Like the music is just, ooh. I feel like I've said it a couple, too much at this point, but the music, it's just great. One of my favorite songs is we just had a music rehearsal last night, and we'd finished the finale, and it sounded beautiful. We did this song called We Beseech Thee, and that's a good one. Light of the World, just some good songs.
We like reenact different parables from the Bible. I really like the music a lot. The music is really good and really fun to sing and dance to. That's my favorite part.
Looks pretty good.
Yep, those students are really talented.
And speaking of talent, we've got a new segment for you guys.
I bet this one has to do with Tay-Tay.
Yep, and as a Swiftie myself, I think you guys are going to love it.
Now let's quit wasting time. Here's Five Star News entertainment reporter, Ben Don't Ask Me.
Hello, generals, and welcome to the first episode of Ben's Bop or Flop. Now, in this series, I'm going to be playing 10 seconds of a certain song and going around asking different students and teachers if they like the song or not. And if they like it a lot, it's going to be a bop. And if they don't like it at all, it's going to be a flop. Now, this week, we have three songs in the lineup for you. We have Blank Space by Taylor Swift. We have 9 to 5 by Dolly Parton. And Just a Girl by No Doubt. Hope you enjoy.
Taylor Swift. I don't really know a lot about Taylor Swift. That did have a kind of a good beat to it. So without knowing the rest of the song, I'm going to say that's going to be a bop because I had a pretty good beat to it. I was actually jamming to it a little bit. I think it was pretty good. I'd be interested to hear the rest of it.
That's a bop. I like Taylor Swift.
Oh, I love Dolly Parton. That's back from my heyday right there. That's like late 70s, early 80s, I think. 9 to 5, working 9 to 5. I could sing that for you, but that would be a flop. But the actual song by Dolly is a bop. That's a really good one. I like it.
That one's a bop, too.
Yeah, no doubt. No doubt they're not on my playlist that I listen to in the car. I'm more of a 70s, 80s, 90s type of guy. But that's pretty good. I do know that song, and I like it. I'm going to say bop on that one. So that's three bops for Mr. Green on Ben's Bop or Flop.
I have to go with a flop. I don't know that one.
I like the new segment.
Yeah, it's pretty sweet, actually.
And we're going to get you on to an oldie but goodie segment here.
Noah, Shane, and Benji are back with another segment of...
What's it called again?
HHS Cool Rides.
Oh, yeah. Well, we're going to get you over to the cool guys. Take it away.
This is my car. It's a Lincoln Navigator. The car that I had previously was giving me some trouble, so I got a new one before it got worse. What I like about my car is that it's big and it fits all my children, and I can still put a bunch of stuff in the back of it.
So this is my Mini Cooper. Back in like 2019, November 2019, right before the pandemic, me and my mom went to go visit my great-grandma in Alabama, and we rented a Mini Cooper, and I loved that car so much. I thought it was the coolest thing, and so we rode in it, and I told my mom, I was like, I want a Mini Cooper really bad, and she was like, you're not getting a Mini Cooper. And so then I got a job, and I saved up my money, and I bought my own car, and I mean, I just really like that, like, it's so small. People make fun of it because it's like, oh, it's such a small car. But, you know, like, look at this parking. Like, I have so much room. And, like, imagine parallel parking in it. Like, I can fit 4 of my car in a parallel parking spot. Like, I parallel park like it's no problem. And in the front seat right there is a cardboard cutout of Mr. Shuler Hensley. He's the host of the Shuler Awards, which is a theater competition in Georgia. He actually belongs to Ringgold High School of Performing Arts.
but I took him, and he's in my car now, and they aren't getting him back.
Hi, I'm Bailey Moorhead, and this right here is my 2003 Chevy Malibu. I bought it last June, I think, maybe July, from my friend for $1,000, and I really got what I paid for because this car sucks. The transmission is shot, and the battery is awful, and it takes like 15 minutes to start sometimes, but it's better than nothing, and it's the only option I have, so I have to drive it.
And with that, we'll wrap up this Wednesday edition of the 5-Star News, and we'll be back with Tuesday with a brand new report.
But until then,
stay classy, Heritage!